Apparently, Republican Senator Lindsey Graham is capable of having a little bit of self-awareness. During an interview on CNN this week, Lindsey Graham actually admitted that, okay, Trump's got some issues, obviously, as a candidate, but the Republican Party in general, Lindsey Graham admitted, they've got some problems that go far deeper than Donald Trump. Now, in the correct context, his statement loses a little bit of its value, but I still think it's worth discussing. So here is what happened. Here's how the conversation went down between Lindsey Graham and CNN host Kaitlyn Collins. Collins asked him, quote, "You're a close confidant of Donald Trump's. Why do you think he has struggled now that Harris is at the top of the ticket? You had said it would be drastically, dramatically different race. Why do you think these last 2 weeks have been so difficult for him as he's been up against her?" And Graham, of course, tried to, you know, downplay it. And he was like, "I think you're going to see a very focused Donald Trump and a Republican effort from everybody to focus on the policy choices she's made." Which, of course, as vice president, she actually doesn't get to sign any bills or, you know, do things like that. So kind of a tough sell there, bud. But, you know, you do you. "He believes he's the best guy to fix the problems we have at home and abroad. And to do that, you got to win. So I am hopeful. Our problems are personality. Their problems are policy choices that are hurting the average American and set the world on fire. If we can get our personality problems fixed, we will win this election because their policies are never going to be fixed by them." And Collins picked up on that. She's like, "Hold up. Interesting to hear you say personality problems at your party's issues. Obviously, Donald Trump's personality. Senator, let me get your take on this." And then Graham cut her off and said, "It's deeper than him. I promise you there, we have a lot of personality problems in our party." Yeah, I mean, I can't disagree with you there, Lindsey. Oh, by the way, you're one of them. Okay, I don't think you realized that when you said it, like, "Oh boy, do we have some personality problems." Yeah, right at the top is you. I mean, you were the guy that went on TV and openly wept when Donald Trump was indicted. You cried on national television begging people to send Trump money after he was indicted. I'd say that's a bit of a personality problem. Honestly, I may go as far as to say that's a bit of a psychological problem, in my opinion. Maybe that's something you need to work through with a therapist if you're crying because some guy you kind of like got in trouble. Okay, that's not normal. It is, in fact, as the Harris campaign would tell us, very weird. But yes, you've got other personality problems. You've got people like James Comer. You've got Jim Jordan. You've got Matt Gaetz. You've got Lauren Boebert. You've got Marjorie Taylor Greene. You've got Louie Gohmert. You've got Ted Cruz. You've got Tommy Tuberville. You've got Marco Rubio. All of those people have very weird and off-putting personalities. And that doesn't even touch the two people at the top of your Republican ticket, J.D. Vance, whose personality has turned off most of the country at this point, and then Donald Trump, who basically has done the exact same thing. But it's not the personalities, okay? You can have a bad personality and still actually be a good, effective lawmaker with popular policies. I mean, let's be honest here. When Bernie Sanders was running for president in 2016 and 2020, people didn't flock to him because he was a ray of sunshine. Okay, he was kind of a grumpy, bitter old man. Rightfully so, by the way. But he was wonderful on the issues, and that's why people gravitated to him. So even if you had these horrible Republican personalities, it's not like putting a nice bow on it suddenly fixes the issue. You can put lipstick on the pig if you want, but it's still a pig. So it doesn't matter if you come out there as a nice, gentle Republican with a friendly disposition. The fact is, you want to strip the rights away from millions of Americans. You're the ones who want to check under their pants and see what they've got hanging between their legs before they walk into a public bathroom. That's not cool. It's very weird. So yeah, this goes beyond just personality. In fact, personality is the least of your problems. The reason people are rejecting Republicans is because their policies are complete and total garbage. Not to mention, insanely oppressive. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and Make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.